Hello, lovely people. It is Francesco, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today, we're doing February's Tools in a Month feature, and we're going to dive into a couple of different productivity softwares that I think deserve a nod this month. This is a monthly segment, and we'll give you insight to new apps and tools. So if you're new here, subscribe. It would be great to have you. And if you're in the hunt for productivity tools in general, jump over to Tool Finder. Today's video is kindly brought to you by AkiFlow, which is a to-do list application which combines calendar and task consolidation. You can find it linked below and get access to it and naturally get the ball rolling, planning your day ahead. So you'll find that linked below. Big thanks to AkiFlow for sponsoring this feature. So Reclaim is my first app on the list. I am somebody that takes ages to review apps a lot of the time. It sounds surprising, but I tend to just get an app and take ages to review it. But I'm trying to do a lot better. I'm trying to get the reviews out as humanly fast as possible. So Reclaim has been on my list for some time, and it's a AI-based calendar app that allows you to essentially go into your calendar and be a bit more smarter with where you're spending your time. So for example, you can use it as personal or team in situations. So you can use this to plan meetings more effectively, get those daily routines in much better, or you can use it for solo use. So in my use case, when I did a review for it recently, which you can find linked below, Reclaim really shone. It connects with Google Calendar. And what I really liked about it is the habits function and the priorities function. So what it does is you can set a bunch of priorities inside of Reclaim. And then what it will do is it will constantly review your calendar and the parameters you set around that priority. For example, it could be like medium priority, needs to be done by this day, and ideal time to do it sort of situation. And basically, which constantly go in the background and reorganize that task to the best possible time for you. And for people who are a little bit more freer on where they spend the time or need that help with prioritization, I really liked it for that. But the reason I think the first time I actually checked it out was when I was doing some research for it, and the team reached out and I did a tutorial, which is very common what I do with probably a handful of productivity tools, mainly when I need more help understanding it. And I want to know the background of the team, because that's also helpful for the research part side of it. And what happened was they showed me this feature called Habits, and I was like, oh, what's Habits? Is it habit tracking? And it's basically where you sort of set non-negotiable tasks or habits that you want to set, like meditation, lunch, meetings, whatever it is, or like deep focus time. And it constantly adapts to that. You set these parameters around it, like lunch, like it can't be later than one, and it will just make sure that those things are protected above the tasks. So there's sort of like anchors in your calendar that just are unmovable. So this works with Google Calendar, and that's why I'm giving it Tool of the Month rating, because I'm very impressed at how it's set up largely. The second app on our list is Affine Pro. I'm probably getting the name wrong. I keep hearing it, and it's a bit like Zapier until you have that context of what it's actually titled like Zapier, Happier, then you will constantly get it wrong. I feel like somebody needs to make that for Affine. I kept going Affine for a while. But I'm very impressed at the application, because what it does is it combines whiteboards and documents, which are messy things because they live in different worlds, they act as different situations, and nobody seems to have got it right so far. I feel like Affine Pro got it right. So basically, you can watch our full review on this, but largely, I like that combination of separation that they have. So like edgeless experience and documents experience. So I'm definitely giving this one a Tool of the Month. I'm impressed with the application. I think Notion is gonna sniff up probably looking at it, because they need something like this to really enhance their experience. And I think they don't have that piece of the puzzle yet, the whiteboarding and a way to translate a document into it or keep the document separate. That's something that Notion would unlock. Like, you don't want a messy Notion beyond it already messiness. So that's something that I think will be on Notion's list. Number three, it's gonna be the big shocker for everyone. Evernote. Evernote has been long sorting out of his infrastructure. Like between 2013 and 2019, it was just like in the dark completely. And then they had that period where Ian came in, did a seemingly brilliant job of like restructuring Evernote, I think, between 2019 and 2022, I'd say probably, where it sort of got a better understanding of what it was. But now they sorted out the infrastructure at Bending Spoons, they sorted out the marketing, and they're now focusing on product. And you can see, I don't know whether you can go on Federico, who is the product at Evernote, go on his Twitter and you just see constant updates within a couple of days that, oh yeah, we're adding this. And it seems like a lot of weight's been lifted out of Evernote, like the bulkiness of the elephant. And I'm actually very excited for where they're heading. I've done a very long article piece, which you can find linked below, which will give you some insight into what it's about and what my predictions are for Evernote going forward and where I feel largely, but I'm impressed and tool of the month. Tool of the month status. So there are my three tools of the month, and I wanted to give them a nod. I hope you enjoyed this segment. If you do enjoy this segment, do like this video and put in the comments below, I enjoyed this segment, or something of those lines, because it would help me understand whether people do find this valuable. Please do subscribe if you're new, check out Tool Finder if you're hunting for tools, and naturally all of the links will be below. So I hope you have a fantastic day ahead, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio. Thank you.